Good morning, guys. Right, so we're moving on quite quickly with our doll, and there's a few things I want to show you this morning, a couple of different techniques, and just how to sew on the eyes, finish this shell pattern on this skirt, and start decreasing on the head, and then I'll show you how to make some hair. So we'll start off. I usually go up about 11 rows for the eyes and leave about 5 or 6 stitches in between. So we start off with a cross. And then we go for a square all the way around the cross. Usually I'll do another cross in the middle because sometimes you can see some clear wool coming through, or some white wool coming through. Right, so that's that part done. Now we're going to go going to count across 2. We're going to do that twice. Then we're going to put some eyelashes on. Go across so that's the basic dark area finished. We're just going to tie these together gently. You don't want to pull on the eyes too much because we could change the shape from the front. We need to tie and cut because if you don't take these little tail ends off, they can show up in the middle here when you turn it over, so it just doesn't look too great. So now we're going to go for the blue. We just use the wrong side. Just make a nice L. Along the bottom, put 2 along the bottom as well. And that's that blue part finished, so we'll just tie these off again. Snip that away. Now we're going to do the white. And keep it underneath the blue, hold the blue, and then allow the white to just sit underneath. I'm going to just do a little light reflection. You really don't pull this because tight because it will get lost. So there we go. I'm just going to tie those off. You can do yours much neater. I was just rushing through that, otherwise these videos would just be too long. So with the skirt, I did the orange with a half double and then a double, and then I did a half double and the red, and then a half double, triple, and now I'm doing a shell, which on this skirt I did just a little frill chain. So I've got another tutorial showing you how to do these shells. They're very simple. Just chain one in into that stitch, skip a stitch, and then do 5 half double crochets. Skip, slip, skip, 5 half double crochets. Slip, skip, 5 half double crochets. Skip, slip. Right, so you know how to do that little shell stitch there. Right, so the next stage, I need to show you how to start decreasing on the forehead. So we'll get to the back center. Right, so we'll start now. We do 5 singles, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now we need to decrease into that one, and then into the next one, and then pull through all 3 loops. Do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, decrease. One, two, three, four, decrease. 1, 2, 3, 4. And we're at the center at the back of the head. We do that last decrease, then we're going to go every 4 single crochets and then decrease. So 1, 2, 3, 4, decrease. 1, 2, 3, 4, decrease. 1, 2, So this section here were all just single crochets. This is where I left you yesterday, and then I just popped single crochets in for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 rows, and then we began decreasing, which is what we're doing now. 1, 2, 3, 4, decrease. 1, 2, 3, 4, decrease. I did notice last night I need to fill this chest area with some more toy filling. 1, 2, 3, 4, decrease. So now we're at the back of the centre of the head again. We're going to start decreasing every 3 single crochets. So 1, 2, 3, decrease. 1, 2, 3, decrease. 1, 2, 3, decrease. 1, 2, 3, decrease. And once I'm at the end of this row, I'm going to start filling that chest and the neck really well, because once it starts to get too small at the top of the head, it's harder to fill. 1, 2, 3, decrease. 1, 2, 3, decrease. Right, so I'll stop there for a minute and just fill in the chest and the neck. I have to make sure we get this filled right, because once we've sewn it up, there's no going back. Well, you could open them up, but it's sad. You don't want to mess up your hard work. The neck's got plenty of toy filling in. And our little neck support's in there now. Nice and strong. That neck feels quite good. So we can stop filling for a minute, because as you can see, it's starting to take shape now. Alright, so now we're going to go to 2 single crochets and then decrease. 2, decrease. Now you can use a marker for this, but I always start a new row at the back centre of the head. 1, 2, so now we're going to do one single crochet and then decrease. So now it's time to put some more filling in. Make sure she's got plenty. So I'm just going to do one decrease again in the next row, and then I'll be getting close to closing up the top of the head. Yarn needle. I'm going to close up this small little hole at the top. So, what we need to do is just weave our way around. slip so the hole doesn't come open. There we go. Right, so now it's time for wrapped this indigo around a pad to make my hair. I'm just going to cut through so that all of the lengths are the same length. So we'll take a piece. Two long bits through, so make sure you line up the ends nicely. Pop your crochet hook through, grab the wool, put it through. I'm just doing a single layer at the back, but at the front I'll use two pieces of wool because that's, you're going to see that more. It's a busy day for the Jets, that's for sure. It's very time consuming, but it does look really nice. I made a really lovely lion for my grandson, Atlas. He absolutely loves it. It's one of his favourite toys, and I presume it's because of the mane. It's made in this way. I hope you could hear me and see this clearly because I have no idea. It's noisy today and I'm not sure about the lighting either. But thanks a lot for watching. Take care. Bye.